Hello everyone! Today I'm going to share a very interesting situation with a customer. In short, he wanted to get reports from Qlik, but not in PDF, PowerPoint or Excel. He wanted the information in the body of the email. So we came up with a very interesting solution in Qlik Automation, and I'll share here the steps and also the code of the HTML so you can do the same thing on your side. Basically, I have here the same chart. In this example, I'm just putting this chart here in HTML, and here is the email format. If I change something, in this example, I'm using infinity to change the data. So I will just quickly change some values here. And you saw that this was the first bar. Now, if I go back to the report, this is the sports pack should be the new version. Let me trigger the automation. And we could use a button to trigger the automation or anything else. Let me get the email here. Just got it, and here it is. I hope you like this tutorial and learned something new. And if you do, please click the like button, subscribe, and check out the other videos that I have here. Let's start here in this application. As you can see, I have here this peak in my chart. I will just fix this. And to let you know, I'm using infinity. So if you need to edit your data on the fly, not only you, but with your team, you can collaborate and just have infinity as your main data entry tool. Now I just fixed this peak. Now let's go to automation. So basically what I wanted to do is to create an email, an HTML email that would be sent via automation. And to do that, all you need is automation. So let's start here with a new automation. These are the blocks that I'm gonna use, but I will start from scratch. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is to go to the mail block, bring here a send mail block. And to use this block, you need to set up a connection. Okay, I already have my connection here. And then you need to specify the recipient of this email. I will send myself this here. The subject and the type. We will send an HTML email. Now let's prepare the body. I'm not an expert in HTML, but I use it ChatGPT. So I said, I need to send a daily report via email. Create an HTML email with the logo of the company and a table for the main content. I copied this code. I have it here in Visual Studio, but you could use Notepad if you wanted. It gave me an image and I replaced it with my company's logo. So I have here Infinity's logo. I just got it from the website. Click it here, copy image address, go back here and paste it in this part. Now I can copy the code from here, go back to automation. And before I paste it in here in the body section, I will toggle this off. This kind of replaces some expressions that we have. So I'll just click it like off. As you can see, this is the sort of ID for this particular object. Now I'll click here in the body section and paste as plain text. Let's click run. And this is the email that I just got. So I have here the logo, I have the report with the table. And what we did with the customer was to replace this table with some charts from the dashboard. And that's exactly what we're gonna do now. So going back to the dashboard, I will first duplicate the sheet. Go to the new sheet, change the name here if you want. So I'll put here dashboard HTML tables. And I will convert this chart here. This is the only one I'm gonna use in this example. So expand it and convert this object into a straight table. Go into charts, bring the table here and drop on this object. I will click here in convert to table, so it will inherit the dimension and measures. And you can start to work with this table, but I have a template here that I will make available in the description of this video, which is this chart. So I have a chart which basically, it's not that easy to work with tables and charts in HTML emails. Some email providers, they block some tags from HTML. So in this case, we had to use tables for basically everything. You will have access to this code in the description of the video. Please like the video. You will see that I have some tags here. So this is the reference of the blocks that we're gonna bring, okay? And just to let you know, in the table, I will have the dimension field, the hash color to differentiate the color of the bar chart, the width in percentage, and the value itself, okay? So I'll create the same fields in this table here that I have in the dashboard. I will just change the name of what I have now. The product is my dimension. Plan is my main value. The width of the bar is basically a percentage. So I will duplicate this field here and calculate the percentage of the total. So it's the sum of the column plan divided by the sum again, but with the total here before the field. Let's convert this to auto. Actually, we can make it number like this. And the color is up to you, but in this case, I will color code according to the product group that we have here on the top. And I forgot to rename here the label. It's actually width in this case. And now a new measure for the color. I'm using a tool called Snip Paste, and besides creating screenshots, I can also see the codes, the color codes. So in this case here, accessories, I will just press C to copy this code, and I'll just put it in here. Same thing for fitness, just changing in the expression. And same thing for yoga. And the name of this field will be hash color, because that's what I have here in my template. Okay, so now in the HTML, we will replace that table that was there, here, okay, with this other bar chart code. But before doing that, let me show you what we have to do in automation. So going back here, let me remove this code, and we are now going to use a Qlik Cloud Service block, which is the get straight table data. If you look for straight here, you will find get straight table data. So bring it after the start block. We need to specify the app ID, sheet ID, and object ID. And we can do a lookup to find all possible values from our tenant. That's what I'm gonna do. It will show me the list of apps. I just need to select. And now sheet ID, let's do a lookup again. I will now select this sheet here, which is the one I just created specifically for this purpose, because we have to convert the objects into straight tables. That's why this object here works, because it will get the data from the straight tables. Click here. Now object ID. I just want the data from that specific object, which is the plan by product. Now, if I bring here this output block, let's just have a look on what we have. So run the code. It's bringing us the same table that we created. And this is basically a JSON list. We can refer to that using this kind of tags from Qlik Automation. It will automatically bring the data from this block, which is the get straight table data. This is the number of the record. So this will bring first the first record. It's number 0, okay, index 0. And then we'll bring the second one, and then the third. And then in this case here, we are repeating this 8 times. So we are bringing 8 bars or 8 records from the table. You would have to adapt this. If you want, you can also create some custom codes with Python. I had ChatGPT to help me with that too. And it will automatically loop on the dimensions that you have to create this code dynamically. I will not go through this on this video because it will be too long. But now going back here, I can attach this block below the straight table. Let me just delete this output. And we will have to paste that piece and replace here the table. So I know that the table starts here, actually in this div. Now I will go to the end until this part. Just create some spaces in between and paste this other code that I have here for the charts in that space. And let's do the same thing. So click here, toggle this off, and paste as plain text. Here it is, and we'll see the value by dimension. We have here the references for everything that was in this other block. And I just noticed a very important point here. I was using the template get straight table data, but you will see that this block here actually has a 2 because I already had another block in my automation. So in this example, I will have to change everything here with a 2, get straight table data 2. Let me do that and go back in a second. Right, so I just replaced everything now with the 2 in front of the get straight table data block. And let's try it out. Let's click run. So it didn't come as expected, as I can see, but this is because some tag is not completed, and also there are some styles in the HTML that are creating these borders. Let me fix this. So I'll go back here to the report, and I'll have to clear these styles for the tables. Okay, we are getting there, but apparently the width is not correct. And we can troubleshoot it by looking at the code, if you know some HTML. I'm not an expert, but here in the email, I can see what was sent. And if we look at the width, let's look for the width tag here. So I just found here, the problem is that the width is coming as 0 point the number and should actually be just a number in percentage. Let's go back here in the app and multiply the width by 100. Okay, so now we should be good to go. Let's click here in run again. And now we're ready. Yep. We got now sports bag, microfiber, exercise ball, which is exactly what we have in the app. If I go back to the previous sheet, we have basically the same chart, but in HTML. If we change something, let's say that now I will change something like exercise ball and just throw here a very large number in this, recalculate. This will now be the first bar. Let's rerun the automation. And here it is. So basically the same chart. Everything is updated. And again, I will leave the HTML here in the description. You can always use some AI tool to help you with that. That's it for today. If you learned something new, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the other videos. See you soon.